Welcome back to Food Fiesta, everyone. Today I'm here in the kitchen to share the recipe of one of the beloved Middle Eastern street food. I'm talking about falafel pita pockets. Now this recipe has three important elements. One is the pita bread, second is the tahini sauce, and third is the falafel. But before I start, I would like to express my gratitude to all my subscribers who have subscribed to my channel Food Fiesta. And for others who have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe to Food Fiesta and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications of my recipes. Falafel pita pockets are one of the oldest Middle Eastern street food, which consists of the warm pita bread stuffed with crispy hot falafel balls, crunchy diced tomatoes and cucumbers, and drenched with nutty tahini sauce as well as hummus. Let's get started with the first element of our recipe, which is the pita bread. I have taken 1 cup of maida or refined flour. In 1 cup of maida, I am adding sugar, because we are going to add yeast. So I have put sugar to activate the yeast. I'm adding here 1 tablespoon of olive oil. You can also replace it with any refined oil. To this I'm adding 1 teaspoon of yeast. Now this is instant dry yeast. 1 cup warm water to knead. Be sure that you're adding warm water because it helps to activate the yeast fast. Now I'm going to mix all the ingredients and form it into a soft dough. Just mix all the ingredients together with the refined flour so that to make sure everything is combined well. Now as you can see, after 3 to 4 minutes of kneading, still my dough isn't ready. It's not that stretchy. So I'm going to spend more 5 minutes to knead my dough. After 5 minutes of kneading, my dough will look like this, absolutely nice and stretchy. Add around 1 tablespoon of olive oil and spread it evenly. And keep the dough aside to rest for about 1 to 1.5 hour and until the dough is well risen. Now let's start the second element of our falafel pita pockets, that is the tahini sauce. For this I have taken 1/2 cup of sesame seeds or til. I have roasted the sesame seeds until light golden brown. After roasting, I'm going to grind it into a powder first. See, it's nice golden in color after you roast it. This is the first time I'm grinding it. After grinding it into a fine powder, add 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Now I'm going to add the olive oil in batches. First 1 tablespoon and then I will again grind it. Then you will see that the mixture is still coarse. 3 times of grinding with 4 tablespoon of olive oil will give you this consistency of tahini sauce. Our tahini sauce is perfectly ready, as you can see. Now let's come to the third and final element, that is the falafel. For falafel, I have taken the chickpeas, which I have soaked overnight, 2 green chilies, which are optional, 4 to 5 pods of garlic, 1 small size onion, 1 cup of coriander leaves, 1 teaspoon jeera, and 1 teaspoon baking soda. Baking soda is going to make these falafels really fluffy. And finally, I'm going to add 1 pinch of salt. Grind all these ingredients together in a mixie jar without adding any water. Will give you a coarse paste like this. To this, add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of baking soda and stir it with your hands in order to incorporate all the ingredients together well. Now we'll start the frying process. For frying, I'm going to take 2 spoons because I'm going to shape the falafel in the form of quenelles. You can shape it into any desired form as you like. I like the quenelle shape, so I'm just shaping it that way. This is the ideal technique to shape the falafel in the form of quenelle. And just put it into the oil. Make sure the oil is medium hot. I will just show you another shape. The quenelle looks really interesting. And it's one of the traditional shapes in which the falafels are done. Now I have added few falafels and have started the frying process. As you can see, one side has already turned brown. Flip it over and fry it on the other side until all the sides are equally brown. I have added few more falafels for frying. Both the sides are already done. It's nice and crisp from outside, as you can see. Here my falafels are ready. Absolutely crispy from outside and soft from inside. At this stage, you can directly have your falafels with hummus or tahini sauce. Now let's have a look at our pita bread dough. It's ready, almost 1.5 hour done. Just punch it down so that all of the bubbles are released. Bring it together on your worktop. Spread some flour and again give it a nice knead for around 2 to 3 minutes, just to make sure the dough is nice and soft. After kneading it for nice 2 to 3 minutes, I have put some oil on my knife and I'm going to cut into equal portions. I've got my 6 equal portions. Now one by one, as you can see, I am taking the ends, the edges of the dough, and I'm tucking it inside just to make sure the upper surface is crack free. As you can see, the upper surface of my dough is absolutely crack free. Take the help of your fingers and tuck the dough inside. Keep on tucking it until you get a soft crack free surface. Like this. Now I'm going to shape all of these into round balls, and now I'm going to start the rolling process. Dust some maida on your worktop and start rolling your pita bread with the help of a rolling pin. Keep on rolling it into the desired size you want, but make sure that the pita bread should be thin. Just have a look. I would have it more thin, so I will just go on rolling 1 or 2 times more. It should be thin enough so that when I put these pita bread on my hot tawa, it should puff up immediately. Now as you can see, I have rolled 4 pita breads. I'm going to keep them for proofing for next 30 minutes, but before that, let me show you how thin I have rolled them. Take a help of a kitchen towel and cover them and keep it for second proofing for 20 to 30 minutes. 20 minutes are done and I have already put 1 pita bread on the hot tawa. As you can see, as soon as you put it, you can see the bubbles forming in few seconds. Release the edges and wait for few more bubbles. Flip it over after a few seconds. Just have a look at our puffed up pita bread. Perfectly kneaded and well-reasoned dough will always result in a nice puffy pita bread. Make sure just press the edges. And here you go. Our pita bread is absolutely ready. Here it is. Transfer it to a plate when it is hot and cut it into 2 pieces, 2 equal pieces, in order to form the pockets. You need to do this procedure when they are piping hot so that the pockets open up easily. As you can see, the pita pockets are opening up easily. Our pita breads are ready. As you can see, I have rolled up few pita breads here and the perfectly opened pita pockets. Let me show you the filling ingredients. Here I have taken green lettuce, some chopped tomatoes, chopped cucumber, and I have added 1 teaspoon of black pepper and salt to it. Next element which we prepared is our falafels, nice and crisp. Next we'll go in the tahini sauce. And the final one is the hummus. Now this is the home prepared hummus. The recipe I have given in the description box. Please do check. And finally I'm going to add mayonnaise to it. Now let's start the assembling process. With few onions. Falafel pita pockets ready to serve. I hope you enjoyed watching today's video. Do make it for your loved ones and let me know in the comment section. Till then, see you soon with another interesting recipe.